Well, it's no secret that the best coffee shops are the ones that you frequent every single day. And so today you're going to be commuting with me over to Los Gatos, and we're going to be paying a little visit to Boulevard Coffee, the home of the Naked Latte. This is episode 2 of Motorcycles and Coffee. Let's ride.
Hi, I'm Steve. Since surviving cancer, I'm combining my two passions, motorcycles and coffee. And so with the help of a few friends, I'm on a journey around the Bay Area to discover great rides and great coffee. And so join our journey. This is Motorcycles and Coffee, episode 2. Well, this is Hicks Road. This is the road that I take to work every single day. It's on the border of San Jose and Los Gatos. And in a certain way, it's a beautiful ride. It kind of reminds me of something that you might see on the Isle of Man TT or something. The beginning part of the road is pretty smooth, but once you turn onto Shannon, the road gets pretty rough. And if you can dodge the cyclists and the traffic, it makes for actually some pretty solid riding.
It's the home of the Naked Latte, but really this is known as the Cheers of Coffee Shops, where everybody knows your name. So I'm going to introduce you to a few of the staff, and we're going to learn a little more about their coffee.
This is Adolfo right here. He's been working here for five years.
And he makes some killer drinks, if you can see.
What are you making right now? I'm making a latte, a double latte.
Okay, you want
to get coconut and almond milk base.
Okay.
I can't live without you. Show me what it is you found my love.
Show me that press. Coconut milk and almond. That's crazy. So this is Humberto. He is the owner of Boulevard Coffee, so we call him El Jefe. Right? You want to tell us a little about Boulevard Coffee?
Well, we've been doing this for close to 20 years. Since 1996, yeah, our coffees, and we get coffees from all around the world. We get them from Tony's Coffee Company, and a lot of our coffees there are award-winning, like a roaster choice. And then we also have the espresso ganache. That one is one of the best espressos that we have in the country right now. We won first place. It's really good. It's a slow roast processed coffee. Yeah, so it's a it costs a lot more money to make that coffee, but it's worth the price.
So what got you into making coffee?
My first wife, Tammy, she always wanted to own a coffee shop. And then she found Boulevard Coffee for sale on the Pulpery, the little newspaper. And she said she wanted to buy Boulevard Coffee, so we said go ahead and buy it. And unfortunately, she passed away on 2006, February 14th. And from there, I've been doing it myself. So
tell me the story behind the Naked Latte.
Well, the Naked Latte is the type of water filter that we use. This is one of the regular filters, and this is called the Naked Lady. It doesn't hold any, when the espresso starts coming through it, it doesn't release it like the temperature, just like a pure regular temperature. it doesn't touch any other metals when it comes to it. So basically, when you get in your espresso, the crema is all concentrated, so you get a better crema quality, and also the taste on the espresso is just better, you know, when it's done with this.
Okay.
And the only way that we do naked, we do doubles or triples. And I recommend people to always get a double or triple latte. This is from a naked filter. Very well concentrated, very solid coffee.
All right, so what's your couple recommendations that somebody has to try when they get here?
Well, the one that most people like and then people always talk about this are Cafe Cubano. The way we extract the espresso, we add sugar into the espresso, so by the time it's extracted, it's already caramelized, and then we top it with half and half.
Yeah. Anything that they recommend is awesome here. Get a crepe if you guys get a chance, because it's awesome. So this is Boulevard Coffee. We'll put the address up on the website, and make sure you try Cubano or Bulletproof if you're brave enough. Cheers.